We're live.
Hello, people.
We're live.
And
this is Commander Shepard what is the name of your ship? I've forgotten.
I'm the Normandy.
That's right.
But you could expect that from me because I've never played the game. But wow. Simon.
It's okay. I'm Commander Shepard, and this is the best pod. This is not a podcast. This is the best YouTube cast on YouTube.
At least your ship has a fridge.
Yeah, I actually don't know. Actually, in Kazumi's quarters, you can get wine. I know that.
Oh, crap.
Yeah, she's got the bar in her area.
There we go. Is that better, guys?
There is something in Commander Shepard's. Commander
hey, Georgia.
Shepard,
hey, Georgia.
Hello, Georgia.
Yeah.
Hey, Georgia.
How are you? You ready to come to Canada?
Yeah. Hello, Frederick.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Frederick. Hello, Frederick. Hi, Bubble Maze. Hi, Lucas. Hi, John McKay. McKay. Depends on how you pronounce it, I suppose. There you go. And whoever else I've missed, hi.
And I'm not in the comments, so I can't say hi, but
hi, everybody.
As you can see, there's some packing going on.
Dean has not brought his blender, so we cannot calibrate Dean's blender. I'm afraid.
I've got a baby behind me. I can't really well set up a blender.
Yes, he had two children earlier.
Yes, that was my...
Dean has been giving birth while you've been off air. I'm
sorry. I have fallout shelter people.
Yeah. Oh, that's why you need to eat, and then as I'm sitting there, I can pick it up.
If I look down, it's because I'm feeding my people and giving birth.
You remember, I started at 6:38, not 6.
Hello, Barringer.
Around 7. I'm pretty good at that.
And, for those of you wondering, Robert is on his mobile phone. This is why we keep seeing his ceiling and cat and various things.
And Sarah. And there's Sarah.
And Sarah. Oh, Sarah. Sarah is packing.
And Sarah's parrot.
No blender, no parrot.
Well, there are a couple of dogs earlier.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Frederick. There are no bananas either.
Oh my God!
I've been up bananas. I'm sorry.
Rub my tummy. Rub my tummy.
There you are, Commander Shepard. There's an order you don't get often very.
Rub my tummy.
That's on the dial options on Mass Effect 3. Rub tummy.
Oh, yes. So, anything happen interesting to you guys during the week? I had an eventful evening, but I'll tell you about that in a minute.
Yeah.
Well, please, do share, if you wish.
Well, let's see, we drove to Destin from Little Rock, and that was a plus 12-hour drive.
Yeah.
And it was warm there. The beach was nice. The water was 90 degrees Fahrenheit.
Ooh,
that was nice. And there was no unusual things floating in the ocean, thankfully.
Did you see any stingrays?
No.
Aw.
I saw a fellow that kept walking like a crab. He was a little too well-muscled.
Was his name Zoidberg by any chance?
I don't know. Was his name Zoidberg? What's his name, Zoidberg?
That dog is just way cute.
Yeah, she's just waiting for her tummy to be rubbed.
That's what you're doing during the week. Rubbing cats and dogs' tummies. There we are. That's a very innocent week you had.
Yeah, I'm sure there's something on Pornhub for
eating,
that.
I was eating American. So I gained a few pounds.
What kind of American did you have?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, well, Let's see. Well, there was McDonald's on the road, of course.
Oh. And you went to the Waffle House, didn't you?
Well, we went by it. We didn't want to get in a fight, so we didn't go inside. But, let's see. Lots of Tex-Mex. Yummy. And,
did you have any fried crab claws?
No. I'm not a big crab person.
Well, cause that's,
for some reason,
that's
I'm not a fan of crabs.
Okay, that's what you might find in those areas, so...
Yeah, we didn't hit the seafood places. Because Sarah and her mother have celiac, so they need to go gluten-free. But I did have jerk chicken pizza, which was very tasty.
That sounds amazing.
And they discovered how much I can sweat when I eat spicy food.
Speaking of spicy food, Lucas says, feed the dog some tortilla chips and hot salsa, then wait.
Well, we won't be around for the aftermath.
Ooh, that could be interesting.
There's the other one. There they both are.
Oh, dude.
You're live on YouTube, you guys. Is that why you're so subdued? You're live.
Hello.
Sonny Milton Keynes, Hemingford Gray. Well, nobody walks in Milton Keynes, so you're all right. You just sit in your air-conditioned car and go from A to B. You're a minor problem of no sound. Well, is anybody else having this problem who is watching? Or is it just Milton Keynes?
I don't know.
Well, they wouldn't be able to hear you.
Well, the food is ready, I think.
People, read my lips. What am I saying?
Oh, and above my charge. Oh, God, I'm too fat.
What are you doing? Thank you, sir. We've got a close-up of your chin.
Something about his fat? I don't know.
You're breaking up, Dean. Stop having a baby.
I'm breaking up?
Yeah, like last week. You're all sort of crackly.
I think it's... I'm not sure whether it's my bandwidth or...
Oh, no.
I mean, we can hear you. So, but you're a bit crackly.
Oh. What? Nobody else can.
People in comments.
Sorry.
Can you
hear me? Am I coming through? Okay. People in comments. Sorry, man. We're boring.
I mean, do you
notice? Okay. I can't stop yawning.
That's a 28-pound backpack.
you're letting Sarah carry that.
Yeah.
Minjiru 88 asks if you're related to Bernie Sanders, Robert.
Well, you would certainly think so, wouldn't you? From all the posts I made. No. I just hope that he will come up and fix Canada after he's done with the U.S.
Well, surely Canada couldn't need as much fixing as the U.S.
Oh,
or Australia, for that matter.
You are aware of our Prime Minister, aren't you?
The only reason I'm aware is because of your posts and Pauline Downey, of course. But apart from that, don't get much news of that down here. It's usually.
Oh, I just spotted a munchkin. There's a munchkin on the loose.
Small ones back there.
That was Jessica. She's just playing.
Bubble May says Dean is cracking. I'm not sure whether that means he's fantastic. Mm. He's cracking, you know. He's great. Whether it means you're... Okay, it's fine now. Okay, fair enough.
Not ready.
Oh, well.
It is ready, but it's sort of ready.
It's better.
So you're getting into practice here, Ren. Commander Shepard, for later. Tell us about later.
Later? Well, let's see. Well, this is Pandamanana and I. Tom and I have been meaning to do this podcast. Well, we've been planning it since December. And I was supposed to come home in April this year, but I didn't. It's going, our theme is obviously video games, it's a gaming cast, but our theme is
Commander Shepard.
Can you feel affection for a program?
Can you feel affection for a program?
For a program.
That was
real affection. Because I've been playing a little too much Dragon Age.
Ah.
Oh, did you just put the things away?
So, I mean, for all those gamers in the audience, MilkJamJuice will be on her channel. I tried to put a link in the description, but if you go to our Facebook page, the link is there, and you click on that, and it will say this event will start in X hours. So you've got plenty of time to have a cup of tea and make yourself comfortable and get your computer ready. And go and watch MilkJamJuice and Pandamanana and Tygrex. What's does he go by the name of Tygrex Games?
I call him Ross.
Ross. Somebody called Ross from Tygrex Ross. Games.
But his channel name is Tygrex Games.
Yeah.
Oh, we'll be back.
We'll be discussing whether you can have cyber love with
the program, and we're going to be talking about AI.
AI, so the crappy AI that you get in some games, and...
Well, and about Stephen Hawking's recent comments about AI.
Ah, enlighten us, please, since we didn't do any research before this.
Well, this was several months ago, but somebody got Stephen Hawking in an interview, and then they just asked him, and they're like, hey, Stephen Hawking, you're like the smartest guy in the world, so... What do you think is like the biggest danger to humanity? And he's like, well, duh, AI, of course.
Ah, that's the biggest danger. I would have thought humanity was the biggest danger to humanity, but then there we go.
Yeah, yeah. According to Hawking, it's AI.
That's probably having a Barney with his interpretation computer. That's what it's like. I said this. No, you did not.
That's incredibly hard, Simon. That's evil but funny. Sorry.
He was really sweaty. He must have a really good antivirus system on his computer.
Well, you'd want to, wouldn't he?
Of course you would, because you're goddamn Stephen Hawking.
Don't hack Stephen Hawking, whatever you do. Because it'll come out in a book and we'll all believe it.
it's going to hit.
I'm sorry, I cannot stop yawning. Whenever this happens, whenever I have to like go on a stage or something, I have this thing where I just can't stop yawning. I'm not tired.
Oh, okay. So this is a prelude. This is a prelude to a spot of Renbot, is it? No.
I would hope so. Renbot. I have to think of a good reason for Renbot to come back. Just something really, really stupid, like cracking eggs on my head again.
we're the perfect opportunity.
Yeah. Do you know how much it hurts when whiskey goes in your eyeballs? Because
what?
There you are, audience. Please experiment and inform us.
I was not aware that pouring whiskey over my face would get into my eyeballs so much and therefore threaten the sanctity of my mucosal membranes. That hurt. I actually had to keep from crying on camera because it did hurt so bad.
God.
Wow.
Why did you pour whiskey over?
Oh, no, I'm good.
Okay. Did you ever see the video where I poured the whiskey over my face?
No. I've seen one Renbot video where you sing quite nicely as Renbot.
It's the Renbot video. It's called, like, a Miracle Hair Mask or something. And, okay, to anybody... Okay, nobody probably knows this because I haven't done Renbot in years, but Renbot is making fun of living dolls. Like, I'm a huge Venus Angelic fan. I think she's hilarious, but it's kind of like a parody of people like her.
Mm.
Only just in a creepy way. like in a just actually just down and creepy way, and like Venus had done like some kind of like natural hair mask video, or basically she just made cake mix and put it on her hair, and I was like, and I couldn't tell if she was serious or not. So just like just to make fun of it, that's what I did. I think the hair mask I had to get in, I had to change into a swimsuit. And then I got into my bathtub, like, and I set up my tripod in my tiny little bathroom at the time. Mm-hmm. And the hair mask, I think I put salt all over my hair. Then I cracked two eggs directly on my head. And then I poured a giant bottle of whiskey on my head.
Oh, God.
And I was like, this will be beneficial to your hair.
I could try to look for it after.
The things we do for entertainment, people. I mean.
Yeah.
How many views did you get?
I don't know, quite a bit actually. I think that was like the that was kind of like the big Renbot video before I just kind of stopped it because I couldn't. I have a couple more with references in them, but they're animations which I haven't finished yet. Kind of like my Final Fantasy video.
Hmm. Now speaking of Final Fantasy, you know what I'm going to ask next, don't you?
No, I don't.
No. Final Fantasy VIII. Are we in the Am I getting warm here?
Oh, I thought you said you.
Wait.
Final Fantasy VIII.
That black thing behind me is where the helmet is sitting right now, and you can't really see much if you can. Yeah. Unfortunately, because I was living away from home for 10 months, I made my last video, I haven't had time to work on it. I started working on Heather because I bought all of my supplies while I was in Sendai and started making everything by hand. But I don't want to sew anything on Edia by hand because I don't want it to look messy. Now, because I'm working on her helmet, right now I'm making hair wefts. Like, those are sitting on my shelf over here, and I have not made a video of those yet, but those are a bitch to make. Let me just tell you, because you have to. I have to take all this loose hair and like run it under a sewing machine, and make it into like lines to put on a wig. And I'm in the process of putting that on the back of the helmet because I'm the only person who's convinced that Edia has. She has a visor on the back of her helmet, and then you can never see it really well in the CGs, like what's under there. But I am convinced that there is hair under there that's pulled up into a bun. So
well,
in
that one sequence, I mean, her hair just sort of flow out or something flows out.
There is one sequence where she's coming out in Galbadia in the parade, and there's one scene where the camera goes behind her head, and she looks down, and under she has the visor on the back too. It's all that's also difficult to see in the game if you're not looking specifically for it, because she's got a visor in the front, and there's a visor in the back. And the front one is the one that magically comes up, but the one in the back is just there. And there is one tiny little scene where she does lift it up a little bit, and you see what looks like a hairline, and there's, like, little lines. And, of course, the CG back then was awful, so it's difficult to tell what it is. But
well,
we
thought it was fantastic back in PlayStation 1 days.
Oh, yeah. Oh no, I cracked my pants when I first got that game. Like, I was like, oh my god, look at those waves. But anyway, so I'm convinced that there's hair under there, and I'm in the middle of synthesizing that. But while I was in Sendai, I was like, fuck it, I don't have anything to do on the weekends because I don't, like, know anybody here, and I'm just, like, cooped up in an apartment, and I've played so much video games that I'm about to go nuts. Mm. So I started working on my Heather top. It's actually finished. I just have to make the skirt and the jacket, and that's pretty much it. And, oh yeah, and the wig. I have to style and color the crap out of the wig.
Not till Monday, come on.
No, that's not gonna, I wish it was that fast.
I only have one question. Why the hell does she have a visor in the back?
That's just how it is. That's how the helmet is built. I don't know what else to call it. It's just like the sloped piece that comes back and.
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. It does look like a visor, and I've always wondered.
And I think that's just.
I'm waiting for the.
Sorry, go on.
I think that's just the legit back of the helmet, and it just balances on our ears.
Very, very that's strong ears, Eddie.
Stuff like that I obsess about sometimes a bit too much. I always think, why do they...
The details, the details. This is the man who's giving birth in Fallout. There we go.
But I still want
John McKay says, I know Final Fantasy VIII, but you played like a couple of hours of it. Get on, John, get on with it. Come on, it's at least 30 hours of game. Come on.
Until you get to like the end and it just becomes an item hunt.
And if you've played all the side missions, it's like all Final Fantasy VIII games. If you play all the side missions, by the time you get to the end of the game, you're so bloody strong and leveled up that the final boss is just a joke.
That's the one game where I got mad because I always like to get like the ultimate weapons, and like the ultimate weapons is such a stupid item hunt because you have to fight all the adamantoises, which are like a 5% drop chance.
Yeah.
And you have to get like 30 of the things to make the stupid sword, and you're like, okay, and you end up fighting like 500 of the things to get however many you need, and it's just,
I did that with Final Fantasy XII. I needed some kind of special bow or something.
Did you try to get the turnus?
Yeah. Oh, God. There's some kind of, like, phantom horse thing that you had to keep fighting. It's going on and on and on.
It didn't bother me so much in 12 because I really liked 12.
Mm.
Yeah, I think I might be the only person who did.
Hey, Andy.
John McKay says Final Fantasy X and X-2 were his faves.
X-2, I like X-2.
I also like X-2. I like the battle system.
And the sphere system as well. The clothing sphere system was quite.
It was basically just like job system. So I'm all about that.
Mm. Oh, I remember in X-2, I had a battle with. What's that little green man thing that comes at you with a lantern? I don't know what it is.
Oh, what do they call him now? A Tomberry.
A Tomberry, but Tomberry King. I was in the dungeons, and you fight him at the end.
And he will come up and shank you. Yeah.
Yeah, sort of like, and I had all three. I had Pain and Riku and Luna, and I had them with their guns. And I had time advance, and I had catnip. I'd given them catnip, just like shooting this guy as fast as they could. I was like, "Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! Please, kill him, kill him, kill him!"
That, or like, you can go into Riku's like final dress phase. If you do like give her a tiny dress sphere that only has three transformations on it, go into her mech like limit break dress, and then she can shoot those things down really fast.
Ah, oh God! There's three women in spandex suits shooting guns at high speed at this little green man.
Well, that whole game was basically that.
Basically.
Three girls in bikinis and we're on the mountain. Let's go in the hot spring.
And I will give you a massage. There was a massage section.
Yeah, what was it? I think I had. Okay, so this came out when I was probably in my second or third, my second year of college, and like I was like playing it at home.
Yeah.
Like in the basement where like my dad was like working on something and like the massage sheen comes up and you're like massaging LeBlanc and she's like oh, and like moaning and stuff, and my dad's like, what the hell are you playing? He's like, it's not one of those porno games, is it? And I'm like, I don't think so.
Just holding Bob.
It was awkward.
Yeah. I'm with Andy. My first taste of Final Fantasy was actually Final Fantasy X, so it's always got a bit of a soft spot for that.
That's good.
The rest
of stuff.
Okay. I missed out on it all. I've never played games, really, until around that time when Final Fantasy X came out. I didn't play games. I didn't play console games. I was
Dane?
Yeah?
Would it be any better on your Galaxy S5? Because you're really crackly here.
Hard to hear.
Just hang on a sec. I'm adjusting my little MIDI mic thing.
Hello, Ben.
Somebody dinged me.
Is that any better?
No.
No.
Oh. Shit. Hang on a second. I'm going to have to shut down my other tabs.
You've got other tabs open. This is our show. You've got other tabs open.
For YouTube, for the channel, so I could see comments.
Okay,
is that any better?
No.
Oh,
come on. Bro. Okay, somebody's messing up. I cannot see.
We can rebuild him.
So please don't message me right now, because I'm not on a computer.
I'll try this. Hang on a second.
Of course, it could be someone that's not watching the show as well. Wow. Well, I have to empty this.
There you are. Anybody who has to empty anything, please do it now.
So I was watching Back to the Future last night because I like time travel.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And that's just one of the best movies ever. And I was thinking about like all of the weird paradox things that like pop up in that movie.
Oh, is that the one? Is the original one where he meets his mother?
Yeah. I'm trying to think. There was like one specific thing that came to my mind, and I wish I could remember what it was. But I was watching it. And I'm like, what? Mostly, it's because like one of the paradoxes I don't understand is like when Marty gets back, like certain things have changed. Like his entire quality of life has changed. So like he has this awesome pickup truck, and like his parents are like. Probably look like they're having an early retirement, and like, so he's got all these great things going for him, which may affect the fact that he was hanging out with Dr. Brown in the first place.
Ah, yes.
But when he gets back, like the new him is still hanging out with Dr. Brown, so like that always bothered me.
Or
the fact that like the skateboarding paradox. So like new Marty when he comes back already has a pickup truck and therefore wouldn't be skateboarding.
You see Dora to try to walk.
Yep. So like if new Marty goes back to the past and he can't skateboard, he can't like outsmart Biff, which would make the paradox like it would like screw everything up. I don't know.
But yeah, this did not in any way affect your enjoyment of the film.
No.
Now you're just... is that any better? Can you hear me better now?
Oh, yes. What did you do?
You
pay the rent.
I turned my little microphone on.
Ah... That would help. So, yes,
it did. I thought it was on by default, but it wasn't. So.
No. Okay. Whoops. That's probably why. Yep.
Yeah. And don't do that. Now you've completely ruined Back to the Future with me, for me.
Oh, sorry.
No. It's all good.
Well, because I've also been playing Life is Strange, which is another like time travel thing. And I was watching Donnie Darko, and Jesus Christ, Life is Strange rips off of Donnie Darko so bad, I just can't even.
2 minutes to leave.
run that past me again. Jesus Christ, Life is Strange.
What? Life is Strange rips off of Donnie Darko so bad, I can't even.
Oh, right, okay. I was thinking Jesus Christ, Life is Strange.
I need to go to some new movie
that I didn't know about.
What was that, Rob?
That'd be a great movie.
I need to leave. My 240 pounds still has to get to the airport now.
Oh, okay.
Right, yes. Oh. Eric, if you're watching, put your clothes on and... press the join button.
Hey, bye, Robert. Yeah.
See you later. Have a good trip. Bye, Sarah. Bye, Robert.
See you, Sarah. See you, dogs. See you, cats.
See you maybe if you... it might join. Oh, he's gone. Yes, I should explain. They are in Arkansas. Yeah, and they are now returning to Canada. Are they? They're both returning to Canada, aren't they? Yes.
Yes, that's good.
So they'll be on a plane watching 2.5 Yardages.
Yay. Yeah. So is this a game that you were speaking of before, or was it a movie that rips off Undarko?
No, Life is Strange is like a brand new game that just came out this year. It's one of those episodic games. And actually, Square Enix is publishing it. But it's like a French developer. But it's one of those choose-your-own-adventure games, basically.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Speed Gimp says that that you look like this, Dean.
That's a paddling. You asshole. Yeah, so continue, Ren. Shepard.
Sorry.
But anyway, it's like you play this high school girl and her best friend, and she suddenly, for some reason, gets the power to rewind time to a certain point.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
I have heard of that, actually. I read about it and thought, eh.
But it's interesting because, like, if you, a lot of things, like the timing, it happens in October, it happens like, there is a premonition where the main character, Max, is like, oh no, the world is going to end in 7 days, and in Donnie Darko, same thing happens, Frank comes to him and he says the world's going to end in 28 days. The world ends with a tornado, like Max is seeing in her visions, mm-hmm. and they're both having to do with basically, like, chaos theory?
Right.
And the butterfly effect.
Oh, yes,
and,
yes.
Yeah, and, like, there's something not quite right with the town, but even the opening, like, camera angles of the first episode and then Donnie Darko are exactly the same. Of, like, going... it's really stereotypical because it's just, like, camera going through a hall of a high school and focusing on kids being kids and being like,
Damn.
They're both excellent, though.
Oh, okay. Well, I might have to have a look at that, then. But, sorry, just had another kid.
Okay.
Oh, this game's addictive.
We need cyber protection for Dean. It's
like... Yeah. My little pixel dudes are breeding like rabbits or weasels or weasel rabbits or something. Fucking hell.
Is there, like, how much time passes in that game? Is it years? I would assume.
I don't know. I've only been playing it for just over a day.
Because, like, when they opened the vaults, it was before the...
Yeah. Mega War, it's changed. So. This is kind of during. I don't know why, but you get people walking up to your vault and you can bring them in or leave them out, depending on what you want to do. Have a look at their skill sets, and if they, if they're okay to bring in or whatnot, you can bring them in or you can just leave them out there to die.
Or you can bring them all in for a cloning experiment.
See, that sounds like a good idea. Damn it, why didn't they think of that?
They'll all only be able to say Gary.
Yeah. Yeah, so, and you get raided as well by raiders. And, oh, wow. Oh, there we go. No, that's not right. Oh, crap. Sorry. Yeah, all right.
Oh, one of the babies just pooped. No, quick.
No, there's happy faces coming from behind the door. They go off behind into a sleeping quarters, and if there's little happy faces appear, it means that they're having pixel sex.
Okay.
I suppose, yeah.
Oh, yeah, Ben, he's playing Fallout Shelter.
Oh, yeah, I can't see comments. Guys, sorry. Actually, I probably can now. Hang on.
Now that you're not crackly,
I can open another tab and put
James says, I wish movie makers would stop dragging Fruit Loop science into sci-fi movies. It's almost as bad as Bible Thumpers using a science. Good point.
Crap.
I'm just replying here to Speed Gimp. Speed Gimp cannot comment from a smartphone, so I'm channeling Speed Gimp at the moment.
Tell him to get his ass to a camera and get on here. He hasn't been on here in months.
There you are, Brian. Get your ass to a camera and preferably show your face on the show. Because you've not been here in
months. Yeah, well, not the ass, because, yeah. That would just be not good, probably. Depends on what his ass looks like, I suppose.
And the sound of fart science. There we go.
Indeed. Oh, God damn it! Now my other window isn't working.
That's a very good point. A very good point, Benjamin Haywood. Talking about time-travelling games and movies, Harry Potter, why didn't they just use that time turner Hermione had to knock off Voldemort before becoming Dark Lord?
I know.
Pretty much, yeah.
That whole time turner thing really pissed me off in the whole series. I really like the Harry Potter series, books and movies.
Mm-hmm. But that
time turner thing, I sat there and just looked at my daughter, my youngest daughter, Jessica, and she looked at me.
I had that
sort of
before I had you. No.
And I think she was thinking, if only I could go back and kill my grandparents or something. I don't know. It was, but that was annoying.
Yes, you're not supposed to sort of like think too deeply about these things. You're just supposed to eat your popcorn and let it wash over you.
Yeah. We're all obsessive over these things. We're all nerds. That's what we do. Actually, there's something called. Have you ever heard of a thing called nerd block?
Yeah, it's not like, about blocking nerds. Full of nerd stuff that comes, right?
Yeah, I'm seriously thinking about getting it.
What's going on, guys?
Hello.
Hey, Eric.
we're just talking about nerd block, which is
nerd block.
Is something you rub on to repel nerds.
No, it's a thing that you subscribe to. You can subscribe.
Don't they just call that?
Whatever.
They don't just call that girls.
Girls.
Nerds have a hard time with girls, from what I've told. Well, from what I've been told.
No. So anyway, yes.
Well, Dean still manages to have babies regularly, so he's a great.
Yeah.
Well,
my phone keeps on going off.
There's like nerd block, and there's a couple other kinds that are basically the same thing, and I think they do like a different theme every month of whatever junk they happen to have in their warehouse they're sending to you.
Yeah. But you get a t-shirt every month it does, because I love t-shirts, as you can
that's kind of the thing. I was going through Ikebukuro the other day, and I was like, I came home and I realized I haven't gone clothing shopping in over a year. Because I've been living out of a suitcase. And I was like, wow, that's really like eco-friendly of me, I suppose. But then I realized I didn't have any like t-shirts that were kind of like newish. And I was going to Ikebukuro, and they had a bunch of Dig Dug shirts.
Nice.
And like an 8-bit. And I was like, that's pretty awesome, except I'm just not much of a Dig Dug fan. So I want to get a bunch of t-shirts like shipped over from wherever the hell they make them. So I went like on Redbubble, which is like a bunch of artists make like fan art and stuff like on t-shirts.
Mm-hmm.
And you could order those. Or like, I really want a Retronauts t-shirt because I'm a huge Retronauts fan.
I think,
which is a part of this podcast.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. I know.
Okay, good.
Have you tried eBay Amazon? That's where I get
I need to try Amazon, but I was like, since I live in Japan, I'm thinking, like, what would be the best way to lump this all in, like, one shipping block?
Yeah. The customs would have a fun time, wouldn't they?
That's the other one, yeah. Benjamin Haywood says, I subscribe to Nerdblock and Loot Crate. Loot Crate is the other one.
Ah, yeah, that's the other one.
Loot Crate. That's kind of hit or miss. I've seen some people get those. Yeah.
Like,
I've seen some people get them. Sometimes they're really good, and sometimes they're just,
I think, like, a bunch of the famous cosplayer girl ladies have videos that may or may not be sponsored by those. Who they have, like, oh, like, Monica Lee does one, Stella Chu does... Stella Chu, by the way, who is my hero, do you guys know who Stella Chu is?
Yeah, I'm friends with her on Facebook.
She's great, and she was even better because I'm sitting here... So the other day, I'm sitting here with my boyfriend, and I'm like, you know, cosplay is really cool. And he's like, well, he's not like my last boyfriend who's like, I think you're a total nerd. He's like, okay. And I was like, no, you don't understand. Let me show you Stella Chu. And, you know, she's a burlesque dancer. So she has this new video out, and she does a strip dance, strip tease, to the song called Eat Breakfast. And she has an outfit with toast for a top. And like a pancake skirt, and then she takes the skirt off, and then she's got a donut skirt, and then she takes all the donuts off, and she has a bacon thong, and then she takes the toast off, and she has like a waffle bra, and she takes the waffle bra off, and it's like it's fried eggs on her boobs, and the whole time I'm laughing at it, but my boyfriend's like this.
I haven't eaten breakfast.
That's him getting ideas. That's him getting ideas. This is why you have all this stuff in your fridge. You know.
And I was like, I've never seen you like that on a YouTube video, but yeah, and that's why I love Stella Chu, and she sponsors cosplay butts. So
yeah,
there we are. We could do that, Dean.
See, that's what I was thinking. I'm going to do. Hey, Jess.
Yes.
If I subscribe to it, I'm going to do my own version of the. Do you know? Are you familiar with Meg Turney?
Yeah,
she does. She's sponsored by them. I should imagine because she does videos about them. I thought I could do that. No, I can't. But anyway,
that would be awesome.
I thought, you know, how many old 50-year-old people do you see on YouTube doing that sort of thing?
Exactly. You can open up a
more
new
and more.
Yeah,
more
and go viral. Your channel would skyrocket.
If the internet has taught anyone anything, it's that you never know what is going to go viral.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Dean goes viral. You heard it here.
No. I couldn't imagine, no. I wouldn't be doing it to go viral. I'd be doing it just because I like taking the piss.
You just like wearing fried eggs on your boobs. There you go.
Exactly. I could do that.
And a waffle jar.
And I could blend, while I'm doing it, I could use my blender to blend something to smear over myself.
Ben Duncan says, why don't you twerk in a bacon thong? There we go.
I could do that. I seriously could.
Got a shame if people... you do that, though.
Wow. you would see the hairiest bacon thong-sized butt you have ever seen.
I watched a YouTube video that told me yesterday that we're running out of bacon in the world.
Oh,
yeah.
All the pigs are hiding.
Yeah,
eating all of them.
Yes, it is Jess. Jess is here. Yes.
Oh, Ren, Jess, Jess, Ren.
In the comments. Nice.
Hello.
Nice.
Hello.
You guys.
Hey, did you finish your cake, Jess? And can we see it?
Oh, I put the black fondant on it. I had to take the ears off. Couldn't get them to attach, so I got to draw on them.
Tell me more about this cake.
I'm making my friend a little kitty cat cake for her birthday tomorrow.
Nice.
That's great.
I done ruined it like 4 times.
Anybody who can do fondant is awesome.
It's not hard. It's not hard.
I can't wrap presents.
I neither can I.
Oh, okay.
Like I
stop using fondant to wrap presents. That's the
fondant is more
it's
giving.
It's like you wrap a cake in
than
fondant.
Wrapper, like, because fondant, yeah, you do it like a cake, but if you mess up, you just take some water on a brush and you just smooth it the fuck out.
Oh.
You have to heat it up.
You can't do that with paper.
It says in the recipe, smooth the fuck out.
And fondant is nothing but sugar and marshmallows.
Definitely.
Message from Speedgim for Dean. I'm sorry, I have to read this here. What does he say? He says, tell Dean I can't go on the show because I'm getting ready for jiu-jitsu. Dean going viral usually involves gonorrhea.
Nice.
He knows me so well.
Come on. Right? Okay. Where is it?
Tell Speed we need to get a picture of him in that new car. I'm not quite sure it suits him yet.
Ah, yes.
I got a lot to say about that car.
That's his wife, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not a Jeep, really, is it? No, I mean, yeah.
No.
That's a little bit not a Jeep, yeah.
All right, finally I got the video up. Hey, Andy. Hey, Frederick.
Oh, look,
I've got a cereal.
Oh, it's Andy. Hi, Andy.
Andy Japandi, Sandy.
Yeah,
Sandy.
That Andy.
Yeah.
Andy, almost not in Japan.
I think the only Andy I know. But still, like,
Andy, I was totally wasted the other week, Andy.
You know, Duncan...
That video is living proof of how every time I tell people, if you're coming to my house and you're drinking a drink I made... You probably won't make it home. No one ever believes me. Zach, that whole video laughing, he hadn't even been at the house for a whole hour and he got trashed that quick.
God. Where did he...
Okay?
Where was he... Was he from Japan? Or did he just come into town?
Zach's from Arizona.
What?
He had been coming back from... No, you don't understand how much rum was in that drink. and how easy it goes down. No, you really don't understand.
Hey, pause on that.
I had an issue with rum a few months back.
The drink, it tasted just like juice.
Yeah.
So you just knock them back, but if you do that fast enough, Zach happens. A drunk Zach happens. So does a drunk
Bernie. I have to correct Bernie here. She says, wait, Simon, aren't you totally wasted most of the time? No, just for 2 hours on a Saturday afternoon. That's it. The rest of the week, I'm entirely sober and utterly dull. Sorry.
Well, I think it was back in January or February, I had an entire bottle of Sailor Jerry's spiced rum.
Oh, I can't drink that anymore.
Yeah, it was a smooth drink, and I was not feeling well, so logically I was drinking a ton.
Okay.
Because I wasn't feeling well, and I thought that would make me feel better, and it snuck up on me very suddenly after like 8 shots, and I'm like...
Were you sitting down most of the time you were drinking?
Oh. Yeah, that's why.
And then you got up, that's why.
And I got up to go use a bathroom, and I was like, uh-oh, I had to do more than pee.
Whoops.
Hi, Tomoko!
Tomoko! Oh, how long's Sean been there?
Yeah, hi, Sean. I got acid reflux, so I can only do, like, rum.
Yeah,
that's a good excuse.
I've just taken a break from drinking for a while. I do the homebrew ginger ale now, but that's about
it. Speaking of ginger ale, my cousin just turned me on to ginger beer, and I've been drinking this called Krabby's.
So I'm hesitant to try it. I'm so hesitant.
Oh, it's so good. If you like spicy ginger ale.
Yeah, it's nice.
It's good.
Which is funny, because I hate ginger. I hate the ginger that sits next to the... Like the sushi. I can't stand that ginger.
That's pickled.
Yeah, that's no good. But this...
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah, that stuff is great. If anybody hasn't tried it...
I love ginger ale. Because I used to drink Jim Beam and ginger ale. It used to be my drink.
Yeah. Well, like, you can make it really easy at home. Just get, like, 200 grams of ginger, chop it up, boil it in some sugar and water, and it'll boil down to a syrup. and then just like strain it out and mix it with soda water, and it's so spicy.
Tomoko says, will there be a pole dance, Commander Shepard?
Tomoko, I'm sorry. I don't have it standing in my new apartment because I don't really know where to put it right now, and I haven't whipped out my stud finder. That sounds terrible. My stud finder. I find the joist in my ceiling so that I do not... Okay, for the non-drywall types in this conversation. A stud finder is a little machine that you use to find the wooden joists in your wall or your ceiling.
Find the wood. There we go. It's a little machine that helps you find the wood.
I don't know nothing about drywall.
Okay, but it's like a little scanner, and you put it over the wall, and when it finds the joists in your wherever you're looking at, it goes beep. Yeah. And so I haven't really looked around the joists in my apartment yet because I have not committed. I have not gotten to that level of commitment yet.
There you go. There's so much you need. There's so much that you don't know about pole dancing. They go around with these little sort of like stud finders.
Well, you don't want the pole to fall over.
Yeah, exactly. If it's not on a joist, it will fall or break your ceiling.
Okay.
And Bernie was evicted by my landlord.
Bernie was afraid that Tomoko was asking me or Dean to pole dance. I'm sorry, that's not good.
Oh,
I don't know.
God.
I think Eric can pole dance for us.
Are you giving me to pole dance?
You can do it.
I'm gonna pole up real quick.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you're the push up guy. You're the push up guy.
I didn't think anybody knew about that. Come on now.
I secretly stalk you, I'm just saying.
Yeah.
But I probably will be putting it in soon because it's a great way to do weightlifting without weights. So.
Indeed it is.
Oh, there's fondant all over my hands.
Jesus. A lot of those pole dancers are nice and fit, I must say.
Yeah. And I... being on the road for 10 months has not done very good things for my health, I'll just say that. From eating convenience store food, like, every day.
Me sitting on my ass all the time doesn't do anything.
You're crackling again, Dean. What have you done? What have you done? You're crackling again.
Okay, like, he's in Australia.
It's that bacon thong. Stop it.
Is that better?
He likes a bit of crackling, you know, does he? Yeah.
Not yet. It's not yet. You're still crackling. Yet.
Still crackling.
You're still crackling. You've turned your microphone off.
Crackling like oat bran.
Crackling oat bran. I love the reference.
What was it? Film Cow does an amazing commercial for that with sock puppets, and it's the best. I hate bran cereal, but it made me want to try some. And it's just like these sock puppets, like, regurgitating into each other, and they're like, crack my oat bran! You know what I can do every day? Fucking eat this! It's amazing. And they also do it, and I saw them, because they do another one with the sock puppets, and they do, Biscoff spread.
Mm.
And they're like, oh, what you making? I'm making a bagel with peanut butter. No, a bagel with Biscoff. And they're like, oh, a bagel with peanut butter sounds so hot right now. No, I'm making this a Biscoff. It's like peanut butter. It's made out of fucking cookies. It is.
It's called Biscoff. That stuff is
great. Yeah, England at Trader Joe's.
Oh, it's so good. It's literally like cookie jam.
Well, yeah, I have three jars of it in downstairs in the kitchen. My kids eat that for breakfast and lunch.
I only had it once, and it was the best time of my life.
Now, speaking of cereal, when's the last time anybody got a prize out of a cereal box?
God, yes, they're giving that up.
Right?
That used to be
awesome. I have kids.
I would dig through that box, get your hand all stuck up with Captain Crunch.
Poor old Captain Crunch.
I remember when
I was doing it right. Put the porn in a bowl first.
Spoons.
Yeah, oh my god, I forgot. Yeah. They don't do those anymore.
What was it? I was watching Charla's videos about Sailor Moon Sailor Moon corn chips. And they had prizes in them, but it was like QR codes where you could get a wallpaper for your phone.
Oh, well, that's not the same.
I did have the Sailor Moon toys, and they were actually pretty good.
Yeah, you really want a Sailor Moon plastic figure. You know.
Yeah, plastic figures would be better. I had a little girl who gave me, not a little girl, she's a junior high school student, who at the beginning of class when I was teaching her, like, our warm-up would just be me asking her about her basketball anime, Haikyuu. Yeah. And she would just get so excited. She'd be like, oh, you know about anime? And I told her, like, yeah, I like Sailor Moon. And she's like, what? And she's like, adults like anime? And I'm like,
uh-huh. In the Western world, we do.
Andy says that the bottom of his cereal box, by the time he gets to the bottom of his cereal box, he's got diabetes.
Oh, he got the whole collection then.
See, I always cheated. I'd always get it out like a big pot, dump it out, and get the toy. And put it all back in.
Oh, God. Speaking of terrible toy gathering, they've had like the gacha machines, and they've had the transformation wands, like life-size transformation wands from Sailor Moon, coming out of those gacha machines at 500 yen a piece. I have finally collected all of them. But unfortunately, my office was next to an anime store in Sendai. So I'd get there Saturday morning when they restocked the machine before the store opened and be like, and like, I think the employees were just looking at me like, what is wrong with her?
Weird.
Yeah. And so, like, this 30-year-old woman like shaking the machine like.
I did that when I first here.
Yeah.
I remember, was it my friend Matt and Jess? No, Charlotte took me out to Nakano. And I found out most of the places on Nakano Broadway will take my credit card. I spent like $200 on figures.
There used to be, not anymore, there used to be a panty vending machine in Nakano Broadway. Because I was there with Jet Daisuke several years ago. And we were walking around and we go by this store and there was a gacha machine. And it said Shimapan, like striped. No. It was OL panties. And like over the cover, it said nobody loses. But it's what it said.
Did they come in a Pokeball and then it said gotta sniff them all on it?
Pretty much. No. Here's the thing. It said OL panties, and then in English it said used, and then next to the used, it had the kanji for like feel. So it was, they had sprayed some kind of chemical on it, I have a feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah. For that
effect. There's another one of those somewhere. One of my friends have been to it.
And Daisuke was like, you should buy one. And I was like, no, I don't want to be a weirdo. But to be honest, I kind of wish I bought one. Just to see, like do a YouTube video about it. But I went back and the machine was gone and I was so sad.
Did you go back?
But Jess, if you have seen one, please inform me.
One of my friends told me they went to one. I have to ask them if they know where it's still at. But there's the one they pointed out. I think they said it was in Osaka, though. It was an actual used panty.
Yeah, I don't know about the prefectural laws. Like, there is like an underground panty market.
Yes, there is. It's in the States as well. It's
There's a video on eBay.
Yeah. People made their money.
Do they take old ones with holes in? I've got a drawer full here of my old.
Well, I think who was it? It was Kaz who posted Facebook, and he's like, why is this woman selling her lace panties? And I'm like, Kaz. I was like, Kaz, I don't think she's selling to women. Because, like, there's comments like, oh, sorry, I didn't have time to wash them. I just Febreze them a bit.
Yeah, this lady did a documentary. It was like a documentary or interview where there was some where she had to have wear them for 3 days.
Yes.
You know, she did, like, specific orders. There was one where she had to leave, like, streaks in them. Ooh. But these people were paying, like, $300 for them like that. Yeah, to have a pair of streaks in underwear.
Yeah,
there were some for the blood streaks, and there were some for the butt streaks.
Oh, God.
It's, I guess it's just sort of like building a custom home, really.
this is three old dudes.
I'm in the middle of planning a custom home.
Oh, I love shows. I love episodes. I love shows like this where it's absolutely...
filth.
And what I heard when I was in college, and this was a long, long time ago, back in like 2004, I was in my third year, and I was living in the same dormitory with my friend who I met in Osaka. Like, we were in high school in Osaka at the same time, and she's like, you know, I've been thinking about doing this part-time thing. And I was like, what do you mean part-time thing? She's like, well, my Italian friend does this, and they might be looking for new girls. I was like, new girls, what do you mean? And she's like, well, it's one of those used panty shops. I'm like, they still have those? And I was like, I thought that was illegal. She's like, no, it's only from vending machines that's illegal. And I was like, okay, so how does that work? And she's like, well, you go to the store, and if they like you, I don't know what the criteria is, like, but... They give you the panties, and then you have to wear them for a specified amount of time, and then you give them back, and they give you like 3,000 yen per pair. God.
Right. Apparently, yeah. Zach says that he saw somebody in Shibuya actually selling panties. There you go. So, anybody who requires used panties, please go to Shibuya.
Although I'm not.
Are you going there, Simon? Is my crackling gone?
Your crackling has returned.
It's back full force.
I don't know that it went away, actually.
No, it didn't. just throwing it out there, you know.
Am I going to Shibuya? Well, I had originally thought of getting a hotel there, but I may take you up on your very kind offer, Jess. Come and stay with you if that is okay.
Not a problem.
Okay.
All I ever ask is that I have at least a 15 to 30 minute warning so I have enough time to put on pants.
this is before I arrive, I presume.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I tell everyone. I want a 15 minute warning so I know to put on pants. Or, you know, if I got sex toys out, I need to put them away.
Okay. Fair enough.
Because let's be real, I don't need to traumatize people with what I have.
I am nearly 50, so I'm fairly resilient.
Nothing shocks.
You're talking to like the one person you probably know that's dated a hermaphrodite.
Okay. Right. Further to Zach's story, Jess, he says the guy tried to offer him a discount. He was like, nah.
You never know if it's that dude that's just out there wearing them around himself, sticking somebody else's picture on there.
Oh, God.
Tygrexgame says, you know, I'm very glad I only ate when I joined in the present topic of conversation in both video and chat. It'll be all right later at midnight, Tygrex. You'll be able to sort of settle down and it'll get cleaner. Although you will have to explain your love for certain programs. There we go.
Yes.
You know, something that's always puzzled me is something that I've always wanted to know.
I am the Great American Challenge. The only traumatizing thing might be the Great American Challenge. I am the Great American Challenge.
You're supposed to do that for the
sick for days.
with hermaphrodites, when they say "fuck me," is it an exclamation or are they bragging?
I really wish I hadn't screwed things up with her so I could call and ask for that.
That's just something, yeah.
Okay, continuing to talk amongst yourselves. I'll just sit here.
Sit there and he'd crackle away.
and making Fallout babies. There we go.
Do I need to Google the Great American Challenge?
Wait, what?
Do I need to Google the Great American Challenge?
Maybe. I don't know. I was making a sexual joke.
Oh.
Oh.
Somebody.
Yes, I was confused.
As long as Ron Jeremy's face doesn't pop up, I'm good.
Okay, I see. That's the first thing that. Doc really? Johnson, the Great American Challenge dildo was the first thing that comes up on my Google.
There we are. We're back in the gutter again. This is the show we love. There we
go. No, okay, I'm sorry. I clicked out of curiosity and I have to look at it now. Oh, God. Okay. Yep, that looks like a challenge.
We should
soda can next to it for reference. That's nice.
We should really
There's
rename
the show.
A person
next to one of them for reference.
Yeah, but people come in all sizes.
No.
And that, now I'm looking at the customers who bought this item also bought. My God.
Let me just
yeah, the funny thing is, tonight I took my son, he's just obtained his learner's permit, but am I crackling?
You're crackling. You're breaking up. You're breaking up. And we can't rebuild you. I'm sorry.
Mad crackling.
Look. It's the size of a baby.
God. You need an operation after that.
This is some hentai shit.
Well.
Maybe it'll fix what ails you.
That was huge.
It'll fucking kill you, and that'll fix whatever's ailing you.
I just had quite the adventure on Amazon.
Hemingford Gray, I thought 3OD aspired to rise to the level of the gutter. We're just below the level of the gutter.
Oh, now I'm an Urban Dictionary.
Oh, dear.
Just came on. It's always going to go to the gutter. Let's be honest here. It'd be worse if Robert was here with me to.
Oh, yes, this is not 2.5 yards, you know.
Yeah.
I found another one. The Great American Challenge is a competition often held at the end of college finals weeks in which teams of four attempt to consume first a 30-pack of beer, then an eighth of an ounce of marijuana, then two large pizzas, and then finish a 100-piece puzzle. Penalties, usually time, are imposed for spilling beer or vomiting.
That sounds like a redneck Saturday night.
Yeah. And the winner gets a 10-inch dildo. There we go.
Oh, God.
Culture. This is what we come to this program for.
There we go. Totally. That's why it's always 18 plus.
Well, no, we removed that, so I sincerely apologize to any traumatized children who are watching. Yep.
Sorry.
That's not going to work out well.
It's okay. Care. Mass Effect is a rated M game. They should have known when Shepard was here.
That's true, yeah.
Should have known things were going to get sexy when Shepard was here. Well, bang, okay?
Zach says, 30-pack of beer, I need to get back to the USA. Just go round to Jesse's.
Yeah. Wow, really, like,
I can take you to Little America. Literally. Every time people come onto the base that haven't actually been on there a few times, like, for them, you cross this line and suddenly you are in another country. They're like, oh my God, it's America.
I didn't go on base, but I went to the, where the hell did I go? I went to the consulate. And the consulate's like that. I went in there and all of a sudden everybody had like American style backyards and houses and it had speed limit 30 mile per hour on the sign and people were like driving on the right side of the road and I was like, this is just wrong. Because it was like this little Japanese Oyaji like security guard who had to check my passport to let me in. I was like, okay, And then I came in, it was like, America! Oh, America! Fuck yeah! And I was like, what happened? And then I left, and I left out of there. It's in Roppongi, so like I left, and then I was in Roppongi again. I was like,
it's like taking a drive through Toontown.
Pretty much, yeah. Like it was driving between the tunnel between real life and Toontown.
Oh, you're back again.
It was intense.
That was weird. Did everybody drop out, or was it just me?
It was just you. You
appeared.
Oh, now there's two of me.
Duplicated yourself. Nice. You've not been playing Fallout.
God, starting. The computers are taking over. There's two Erics.
I bet that that one process started on my computer. Yep, there it is. Anybody know what the NACL64 Google Chrome process is?
That is the NSA checking you up. Because
that's probably what it is. I'll delete this and everything will start working again.
Or maybe you just need to stop watching porn so much.
And there we go.
I have to tell.
I ain't gonna make no promises.
Okay, I have to tell Commander Shepard from Zach that he sang "America, Fuck Yeah" at the Yakosini Shrine today.
Well, that's like a kick in the face, but okay. I don't disapprove. I do not disapprove. I actually think we should just change the national anthem to that.
Right? Because that's how it is anyways.
I know. Cause like,
or American military, I can say this.
I was at a party and people were like, Lauren, that's my actual name. And they're like, Ren, you should sing the national anthem. And I was like, I can't. They're like, what do you mean you can't? Are you afraid of singing? I was like, no, I just don't know it. And they're like, why don't you know it? You're American. I was like, we never had to sing it in school. We had to say the pledge. I can tell you the pledge. But yeah, if we changed it to America, fuck yeah, that would be much easier. Because I think it just applies more to our current situation.
Yeah. Andy, you traitor. You're going to Texan in Tokyo's live show. Well, there will be no dildos. There will be no America. Fuck yeah. There will be
no. No, you don't know.
We don't know.
No, she would never do that on live.
Andy, tell her to come and have a look at us.
Yeah, go cough him out, Rudy.
Get some tips.
So, in the span of being on here, I killed, like, this much already.
Jeez. Is that white wine?
It's rose wine.
Oh! Nice. Ditto.
I'm being a prissy bitch.
How much have you drunk? How much have you drunk, Jess? I'm down to this one.
Well, over half the bottle.
Okay, well, that's about... Oh, I'm...
But yeah, I started when I came on. Come on, woman.
I've got to save this for tomorrow.
I got jello shots in there. I still haven't finished those from that breakfast party.
Hemingford Gray says Grace may have handcuffs, though. Okay. Hemingford Gray knows something about Grace that we don't.
Oh, no. In one of her videos, her husband has handcuffs on his umbrella, and then he handcuffs her for doing illegal things.
Okay.
He's silly.
Yes. So she's not like Caffeine Jedi then. Okay, fair enough.
No one is like Caffeine Jedi. No, that's
true. If you're watching this on the replay, Stephanie.
Yeah.
They're picking on you.
No.
A kill.
Yeah,
she hasn't been on in a while.
She has not. And we don't know why. I do
know why. She's been extremely busy. She's I was just chatting to her before. She's getting her show reel ready for her directorial debut.
Nice.
And nice. Drowning in Sunshine, the first episode, is completely in the can and all ready. So only sort of like 6 or 7 more episodes to edit.
Wow.
So, recently, I haven't, well, before I stopped uploading videos for a year, I had been getting complaints on my comments, because I when I talk to myself on the camera, I'm always like, And I started getting a lot of complaints about it. So my last three videos, I've actually gone through and manually removed all of the ums.
That explains. I mean, when you were doing your cosplay video, it was like
It jump cuts. That's me cutting all the ums out. That takes so freaking long. I haven't realized how much I say it.
You're very good on this show.
I don't know why. Because it's, I guess it's when I'm talking to other people, I'm fine.
Oh, yeah, but yeah. You've got to talk to camera.
To myself, like it, yeah.
That's why I can never vlog. I can never vlog, just like holding the camera there and just feel
that's
so
why you get a tripod.
What you're trying to say. I think it's a sign of intelligence. Because I do it too.
Yeah, but when my count hits like 300 on a 10-minute video, it's not good.
Holy shit.
Like, not really, but I edited a 14... I know, I edited a 16-minute video and it ended... No, that wasn't 17 minutes. But I edited a video and I ended up taking like a minute and a half off just from the ums, which was bad.
I think.
Yeah, you should publish that.
I should, and I will PM everybody who ever complained about it.
Come watch it. That would be great.
Do it.
I am actually that sounds like I will save all of my clips and upload them to a separate file.
it appears you may have a problem on the live hangout later because Tygrex says yes, he has an problem. When talking to camera.
That's fine. Well, no, he won't be talking to a camera. He'll be talking to me, so it's all right.
Oh, there you go. You're all right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You could always consume half a bottle of wine, Tygrex. That helps a lot as well.
Just half the bottle, though. Just half. Yeah, the bottle.
We should get like 2 hours before we start.
Don't be wine wasted.
I have one like Jim Beam Highball canned cocktail in my refrigerator, and that is it.
Highball.
I have a bottle of a raspberry beer.
So does it taste very raspberry or more beery?
It tastes actually more raspberry. It's it's like Belgian beers. They like to sort of like make cherry beers and raspberry beers.
I do like Belgian beers.
Bring one of those with you. That sounds wonderful.
So that, if I can get that in my luggage, that will be.
Yeah, put it in your checked-in baggage, and you should be okay.
Have you all ever had mead?
Yes.
Yeah. No, I've not.
I never had mead until I went to London, and then I bought some, and I brought it back, and it's just like drinking honey. Except
very
it's
sweet.
Alcoholic.
So fucking good.
Pretty high for a wine.
One of my I'm trying to remember where they're from. They're Nordic. But one of my Nordic friends brought some over. Like I fed them dinner, and they brought some over that they had their parents in them or something. I can't remember. But that shit was fabulous.
So good.
You can see why they drank that shit like wine. I felt like a Viking. Yeah. It was great.
Well, technically it's wine. Just not made of grapes instead of honey.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I was talking to like the curator's assistant because I was at Hampton Court Palace, and they're like, yeah, they used to drink this before jousting, and I'm like, that's a good idea. give me some courage to stick a lance right in somebody's eye hole. Okay.
8 years later, they were the ones we sent to America.
Yeah, but I was like, well, you know, I guess if I were living 500 years ago, I'd do the same thing, too, so.
Yeah, you didn't live, like, what, longer than, like, 30, 40 years? Fuck it.
Pretty much, yeah. So if you're getting, you know, if your lifespan is 30, I'd be dead at this point.
Right?
And I'd just be like, well,
I'm pushing 30.
That makes me and Dean the old wise ones.
You guys would be like
Dean might even be a wizard.
You would probably be called wizard.
Or a shaman.
apparently, this is a message from Speed. Your beer is probably beaver ass beer. RE Castorirum. No idea what he's talking about.
There's only a few people who speak speed camp.
Yes. Anybody from Florida in the comments, please can you translate?
Wait, Florida?
No, I'm from Georgia. That's close enough.
Oh, I'm from Alabama.
There you go, speed.
It's a southern revolution over here.
Woohoo!
Minus dead black people.
But I love how neither of us have accents.
I caught that, Jess.
Okay. All right.
Y'all got it. Excuse me.
Gary made the Tygrexgame laugh so hard that he needs his inhaler. we do that often. Oh, I'm in messages again. It's either Zach or Speed. I'm being channeled. You have to Google Castorarum.
What? Castorarum. That's a lot of work.
It's C-A-S-T-O-R-E-U-M. It's probably some disgusting...
C-A-S-T-O-R...
Yeah, pretty know that if you Google anything that he sends you or look at pictures he sends you, it's probably something disturbing.
The caster sex. Yeah.
Hold on. I'm Googling it.
Oh, God.
So that's what castor oil is.
Oh, that's kind of like Shiako, though.
Can you enlighten us? Because I didn't.
Shirako. Japanese people eat fish balls.
Okay.
They eat every part of the fish here.
English people eat sweetbreads, but there we go.
Yeah, well, that is a thing. And there are Rocky Mountain oysters.
Straight from the Rocky Mountains.
And Captain Crunch.
How's that river in Colorado?
And Captain Crunch, really?
Oh, no, that's way far south.
Oh, okay. Just thought I'd ask, because I'm not doing much. So.
Yeah, you hear about it on the radio all the time. They did. They just now opened up the people's public wells again so they can use them, but they still suggest that they don't use them, but they're allowed to if they want to.
We suggest you don't use them, but we're opening it anyway. Feel free. Yeah.
You may die. It's your choice.
Earlier tonight, I took a trip with my son to Gawler. So he's just obtained his learner's permit, and I let him drive to Gawler. On the way back, this happened on the way back. On the way back,
he had his voice abducted by aliens.
Yes, car coming towards me looked like it was swerving a bit. It was driving a bit erratically, and I thought, I'll slow down. Didn't do much good. The guy crossed over to my side of the road, so I thought, fuck.
Oh, shit.
I crossed over to the right side of the road. He then accelerated and did a graceful 180 in front of me and ended up looking back the other way from which he was coming. He missed my car probably by the length of my penis, which is about 1 or 2 inches. And... I'll get to that in a minute, though, because it was a very, very short thing. I said that to the cop. Luckily, I jumped out the car, went over to check on the guy. I thought, well, he might have had a stroke or something, you know, or he's pissed, one or the other. And, I didn't smell alcohol, but he just didn't seem to know where he was. So he was putting me on ice.
Australia, Mike. You're in Australia.
Yeah, you sure you weren't in the field like a madman?
He kept on repeating, where's my bloody... Oh, I can't swear now. Where's my bloody wallaby? Anyway, I noticed that there were flashing lights behind me. There was, luckily, there was a police car, like 3 or 4 cars back behind me. And they turned their lights on and came up and, oh, can we talk to you? I went, yeah, well, of course. And they asked me what happened. Hello! And, so I explained to them about the whole just missing me. The cop smiled. I won't go into detail because of the little one. But what I said...
I got the headphones on.
I said exactly the same thing to the cop, and he literally almost collapsed laughing. So it was not a waste of night. But yeah, we don't know what was wrong with the guy. They rang an ambulance and it came and took him away. And I continued on my merry way home. It was a night of excitement for me. That's all. I'm done. Continue.
I have a message for you, Dean. It says, my God, can you please restart your modem?
There's somebody on the phone on the other line.
Yeah, I kept hearing voices coming through. See you, Frederick. Frederick's got to go to a concert and assist.
Oh, goodbye, Frederick. Yeah,
no, punk rock concert? Better be a punk rock concert.
If there was more than like half an hour left or something, I'd restart the modem, but there's only 5 minutes
left. 5 minutes left, yes, it's, yes. We'll just have to deal with your crackling for the next.
Yeah, I'll just sit here, continue talking amongst yourselves.
So, how long have you got before your next hangout, Commander Shepard?
An hour and a half.
Oh, are you maintaining your persona?
Yeah, because I don't want to take this off yet because it'll stay on forever. It's like I told you earlier today. It's basically just like smearing wax all over my face.
Oh God.
which takes forever to put on. Like I don't. It's hard to like show, but
is it hot when you put it on?
There's an adjustment period for the wig. So like it basically smothers your scalp, and these things are hot, and it is, oh crap, I just got my scar wax. But yeah, these wigs are extremely hot, which is now why I am not wearing the N7 hoodie right now, because it is 35 degrees outside.
Oh God, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I mean, you've not got the full armor and helmet then.
No. Hell no. I would like to make it though.
Yeah, I was looking before on this. I was thinking, how can I had like 2 hours to go before the show came on. How can I whip up a Garrus Vakarian mask out of cardboard in 2 hours? And I was looking on Google Images.
Yeah, I know.
No.
What was it? My friend who originally cosplayed Shepard with me for Halloween a couple years ago, like we bought the hoodies together, but I just kind of like went all out with the costume after Halloween. But we made the same. We're the ones that we made the guns together, and she got like the N7 custom printed dog tags for us. And her boyfriend, also who's Japanese, who she forced to play Mass Effect, he really likes Grunt. And he's like, I want to cosplay Grunt. She's like, we cannot sculpt and latex like cast a freaking mask for you. And she's like, why don't we just print out a picture of Grunt and cut some eye holes out of it and just put it on your face. So Simon, you could do that. You could just print out a picture of Garrus.
Yes, Garrus Vakarian. Yes. I'm getting a message from left, right, and centre here. I have to pass a message on to Dean. It says every time you sort of you lose your voice, a fairy loses its wings. And you can help by saying aloud, "I do believe in fairies. I do. I do. I've seen them. They're down in South Beach."
I do believe in fairies. I do believe in them. Is that okay?
You're saved now. You're all right now.
Thank you.
Now click your heel three times and say, "There's no place like working modem."
If only.
Australian internet. Sorry, yes, carry on.
I just love Wizard of Oz. It's so great.
It's about time they do a remix, isn't it?
Remix of Wizard of Oz? No!
Bring back the Wiz. Let's see a remake of the Wiz.
They did one recently. It was called like The Great and Powerful Oz, and I just couldn't see it because I didn't want to ruin my life.
It was all right. I actually watched that on the plane
I watched the one with The Return to Oz, that one that scares all of the children from ever wanting to grow up ever.
Oh, my That's awful.
The one where the witch like decapitates herself over and over again.
Yeah. Yeah. She's on your shelf behind you.
And it's the little girl who plays Dorothy eventually plays the bad witch on The Craft, by the way.
Oh, yeah. What's her name? Yeah. The one that goes
I forget what her name is, but that's her. I don't think she's done anything since The Craft. But...
Not really.
No. Maybe,
oh, hang on. What was it? Happy Gilmore. She was in that.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm not... I watched Happy Gilmore, but I was not much of an Adam Sandler fan. Just after... I liked Billy Madison, and that, like, yeah. Every other movie after that was just Billy Madison in different situations. So I'm just yeah. Like, eh. Well, Waterboy hit home with me because it was in Indiana.
Sorry, it was Waterboy, not Happy Gilmore.
Oh, okay. I think, was she the girlfriend?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah, because he drives her home in his tractor. I did enjoy Waterboy because of that.
Yeah, Waterboy's
alright. Reminded me a little bit of my youth. So.
Wow. Cool.
Yeah, you ever helped out?
Do you have some My Mama Said stories?
By the way, yeah, I love Southern Women Channel. It's actually the greatest ever.
Right? That's hilarious. Southern Women
Channel. Okay, yeah, thank you. My mama made me do it.
There you are, people in comments.
Why did you get dropped on your head?
Or what was it like? They talk about picture day being hell for Southern girls, and I can confirm that. Because I was in elementary school in the late 80s and early 90s, and my mom's like, we got poof your bangs. And, like, my bangs would be like, whoo! They look like the NBC logo.
Yeah, like, if you want to know what we're talking about, just look up shit Southern women say. There's, like, a couple episodes of it, and the shit is hilarious.
And it's like, I watched the first one, and I was like, oh, I didn't realize only Southern people talk like this because my family talks like this. Like, oh, okay. Jesus. Yeah, that's.
I lost the ball to my fucking livery.
No. Uh oh. You need a magnet. That's what you need.
They're not metal.
They're not metal. Oh right.
This, Daddy.
Oh yeah.
Go and explore.
What did she drop?
Whoa! She just fell off her chair.
Apparently
I was going to explore.
The witch from The Craft was also in American History X and The Island of Dr. Moreau.
Ooh, okay.
Fun facts, fun film facts from Speed Gimp there.
Perusable. Yeah, here's the thing. I looked on IMDb today because I was watching the Back to the Future. Michael J. Fox is actually older than Crispin Glover.
If I knew who Crispin Glover was, I would...
Crispin Glover plays his dad. Crispin Glover, sorry. Crispin Glover is also one of the best freaking actors, like, ever. And unfortunately, he just gets crappy roles.
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't really remember much about the dad in Back to the Future.
but anyway...
I think the thing that everyone remembers is the interview on David Letterman, where he... he was completely on something. Maybe it's just like that all the time. But I like him. I do. I think he's funny. But the upstate there was some comment about kicking someone in the face, and he showed Dave and missed his face by about a hair's breadth. Dave looked a little surprised. It was funny, but kind of reminded me of that interview that he did with Joaquin Phoenix, the beard, and that nobody knows what I'm talking about, do they?
Okay. No, and you're crashing like God knows what.
I can barely tell what you're saying.
There's all these dead. There's all these flightless fairies are sort of like going fucking Dean.
Yeah, It is after 11 o'clock here. Should we end the program?
We can put people out of their misery who are watching. And we can remain here and entertain ourselves in the after show, should you so wish.
As opposed to the afterlife.
We shall put it to the vote. Who would like to go off air and carry on?
Well, I'm going no matter what happens.
Oh, that's an anticlimax.
Either way, for me.
Just says he's gargling again. Okay, I'll tell you what. We shall put people out of their misery, and the fairies will throw up their hands in a sigh of relief. We will end the show now, and I'm not quite Robert, so I'm not quite sure how to I could always put this link on Facebook or Twitter, and
I suppose that might work.
Yeah, we can see if anybody feels safe enough to join us. But thank you for watching, everybody, and we shall join you next week with more tales of the unexpected. Okay, thank you, everybody, and don't forget to if you aren't already watching, check out Texan in Tokyo, a much cleaner show, and check out in about an hour or so, go over to
hour and a half
Ren's channel for more of the same but cleaner. Okay, thank you.
And probably better.
Okay, bye everybody, thanks for watching.